to you on this late January day. I am videotaping my church council president's message to you because at this very moment I'm probably getting ready for bed in Iringa, Tanzania, where Ken and I have been since we left Burnsville on January 18th. We are 9 hours ahead of your time. I hope this message finds you all well and looking forward to the promise of a new year of ministry at St. James. As many of you know, this is not my first rodeo with the church council. Ken and I joined St. James in the mid-80s, which makes it about 35 years that we have been members of this congregation. In this time, I have served 2 terms on the church council, and this is my first time as president. A great deal has changed in this time. The pastors, the makeup of this congregation, the larger church, our financial situation, our staff, our priorities, and the needs of this world. The one thing that has always remained constant has been the presence of the Holy Spirit and the love of God supporting us in all our efforts. Perhaps some of you wonder why I considered serving on the council after all this time. Why not let somebody else do it? There must be plenty of other people who would like to be leaders in our congregation. And if there are, I'll take your names for next year's nominating committee. To be honest, saying no certainly crossed my mind. I'm here at church a lot the way it is, and so are many others. I said yes when asked to serve because of the amazing opportunity that St. James has to move into this decade with a new outlook on the mission that we share. We have the chance to create our own future as we decide how we want to be God's hands and feet in this world. I know that we can't be all things to all people. However, with intention and direction, we can be effective and significant in the things that we choose to do. This brings me to the formation of the strategic planning team in the partnership with Vibrant Ministries and Jim Ledoux. This was the first item on the agenda for the church council. It was to decide how, as a congregation, we are going to approach the anticipated change in our financial status with the current mortgage paid in full. After thoughtful and thorough discussion and planning, we chose to hire an outside source to help us with this plan. This included forming a mission team of 7 members who would work with Jim to formulate this plan in conjunction with the council and with the congregation. The council suggested names of people that they thought would be careful stewards of this task. I volunteered to contact these people, and I was overjoyed when every single one of them said yes. Over the last 9 months, these dedicated volunteers have spent countless hours working on the presentation that they will share with you today. They have asked for feedback at every turn. They brought their ideas to adult forums, and they've checked with current demographic and statistical information to give us the best options for how St. James can impact the future in this community. They have my deepest thanks for their dedication. When I look back over the past year, while the strategic planning team has been foremost in my mind, I also want to highlight another area of ministry that the Holy Spirit actually brought to our door. Late summer, a group of individuals came to the church office. They came because they heard that St. James was a welcoming community, and they needed a place to worship. They had inquired elsewhere and had been turned down, and were now somewhat desperate. They are a Spanish-speaking Pentecostal congregation, currently meeting in the basement of a housing development. We already have another Spanish-speaking congregation worshiping here. Well, why not two? We have the room. The idea was considered, brought to the church council, and unanimously approved. The other exciting part of this adventure is that the leadership that has been taken care of by two members of the congregation who speak Spanish and volunteer to act as interpreters and work out the details for this arrangement. Any of you who attended the potluck that was held for all three congregations together on the Sunday before Thanksgiving saw what a success this partnership has been. This is a gift of our space to those who need it and has enriched all who have participated. At the retreat held the first weekend in November by the strategic planning team to gather input from the members of the congregation on what their thoughts and dreams were for the future of St. James. One of the exercises included listing all the things that this congregation, our congregation, does to deepen loving relationships with each other, with God, with our neighbors. When we began putting these things on the board, the things that we do on a daily, weekly, monthly, or yearly basis here at St. James, it became clear that this congregation is very busy carrying out the work of God in this time and in this place. So many activities are done, both in the church and in our community, by the members of this congregation because they're engaged in carrying out God's work in their everyday lives. Many here today are those very people, because just by being here, you show your engagement in the work of our church, both inside and outside our walls. My challenge to you today is to reach out to others at St. James and encourage them to join you in the activities that you are passionate about and that you engage in. These are could be community ideas, they could be church ideas, family ideas, anything that helps further the mission statement of our congregation. Let this be the beginning of a new era at St. James, where we are all a part of the change that we are hoping to see. Thank you for the opportunity to be a part of this adventure. Thank you to the Church Council for their support. I look forward to the next 2 years and all the amazing opportunities